Hey, it's Fran again, doing mission log number 6. Boing! Day 14. So, yeah, today it's the 28th of June, 2 weeks in, and a lot has happened in the last 3 days or so since the last update. The project went public ahead of schedule. I had gotten notice earlier in the week that the powers that be were going to declassify the project by today, and they ended up moving that up a few days, a couple days, and doing it on Wednesday. And I woke up in the morning Wednesday and it had been declassified, so patrons got the first look at the first mission log and learned about what the secret project was. And I think as of today, well, later today, Mission Log 2 will be published. But I've had, you know, 2 weeks of these logs. And since the last log, like I said, a lot has been going on over at the factory. The first thing that I did since the last log was bonding the first of the assemblies. Because in order to get the accuracy and also to accommodate grain direction and working around the realities of the wood, the walnut that we're using, I had broken down the designs, the paper designs, into to break down the various parts of the assembly into subcomponents. What I had to do initially was I had to bond the rotor head to the second layer of the rotor assembly, and I did that in a vise and using a true bond 3. And so I clamped the rotator head and got that done, and I got that in a rough form, which I'm going to have to hand finish. And also bonded the puller, which I had made in two halves, so that I could get the maximum number of milling operations with the origin and get those sort of radiuses that I wanted around where the bearing goes in, you know, to get it, you know, as written on the sheet. And I had to bond those two together along with a bearing tube that's going to not only hold the two in alignment, but also be the bearing for the pin that's going to be going in the base. And so I got those glued together, and I had to start doing the hand finishing operations. So I knew that in order to do the remaining operations on the base, that is the drilling and the contouring of the radiuses or the radii, and also being able to handle the small rotator head and being able to drill it and cut it and shape it, and also the latch arm, that I had to come up with some squaring blocks. And that was a major task this week, to design and fabricate and finish and square and true these squaring blocks, and using a protractor and just translating angles from the paper designs, doing some calculations to figure out the, you know, the negative angles I would need for the blocks and such, and then using the protractor to scribe them out on some scrap pieces of wood, and then cutting those pieces of wood down with just a regular jigsaw, and then putting them on my table sander to get them squared and trued so that they really were at square, and have the and checking the angles with the protractor to make sure that the angles for the working angles are correct, so that when I'm actually doing the operations on the drill press or on the sander, that I am at the correct angle. So that's going to be, you know, square on the piece, because we've got these odd angles here, and I'm going to be running 90 degrees here. So basically getting all the angles to add up to 90 for doing the operations on the press and the sander. I made the one for the base out of a remnant of those blocks that Scott had trued and squared and planed for the doing the shape or origin stuff. I had a bunch of those left over, and so I took one of those that was the right size, and I milled out with the shaper some recess holes that would line up with the base artwork, and then pocketed out some holes within those holes to force fit some nuts in there some quarter inch and number six nuts just so that I could use some existing hardware I had to hold that base to the squaring block, and then that squaring block is going to be used to do the remaining operations on the base. And then the two blocks I made, the one for the rotator head, I had mounted the rotator head to that with a screw through where the bearing is going to go, just to hold it firm, and with a washer, and also a little bit of two-sided tape under it to keep it straight and true with the line so that it's not going to wiggle around or want to migrate while I'm doing the operations. I did the same thing with the latch link block, which has a piece of tape, and also because it's so small and delicate, I couldn't depend on the tape to hold it in place during drilling and grinding, so I had to fabricate this little tiny aluminum plate, like a little cross plate, that is going to be screwed crossways over the top just to hold down that latch link to the block so that it's not going to fly off the the tool while I'm, machining it and doing these last processes for the latch link. I have yet to actually do the latch link, but I've done the rotator head. I, hand contoured a radius on the head as per spec and had this amazingly complicated clamp down setup on my drill press that I've ever done for a single hole. So the squaring block is in a vise. The vise is clamped down to my special custom drill bed, which is made just for clamping, and so it's clamped in place, but also clamped in place are, I have these shim blocks underneath as a follow-through so that, there's something for the drill bit to hit so that it doesn't, burst out the bottom, and that had to be shimmed up, and then that had to be clamped in too, and I doubled up with shims, and it was just this, and then getting that, all of that aligned required me to tap with a hammer. I was tapping here with a hammer there, just tapping it in place and checking with a magnifying glass and tapping, and then just, touching off the bit to see where it's, because I had put the crosshairs for center on that using a process with a compass, because I've got, I'm using from my 1940s era drafting set, had this compass that was just for scribing, and I've been using that precision compass to translate, take it from the caliper by using a magnifier to, line up the centers of the compass pins to the edge of the caliper, and then translating that to the actual parts using squaring blocks, and so that I have a squared surface to go from as a reference with the compass, and I scribe into the wood, in the two different directions, and that'll give me a crosshairs, and then just to highlight that, I'll sharpen a pencil very, very finely, and then go ahead and put the pencil in that groove and just kind of highlight it so I can see it a little better, and use that to scribe the radiuses that I'm going to need to do, and again, highlight that with graphite. So we're into the old school stuff now. I'm using cabinet making and clock making, techniques, centuries old stuff to do the finishing. So we started with CNC, we're ending with centuries old cabinet and clock making techniques. But that's how that's how I want the factory to be. The whole idea of the factory was to combine the old and the new. The most charming and traditional ways, merging it with the most modern, practical, and accurate. And that's sort of the whole purpose of the factory. And adding to that was a combination with these, the bearings and pins, because my assembly, even though, and this is one of the things about Project Egress, we were all told that our assemblies did not have to be functional, they just had to be cosmetically made to specifications to fit in this model. But I decided that mine would be functional completely, and so all of the actuated parts of my assembly are going to have brass bearings and steel pins. It's going to be completely articulated, smooth and goosey, and completely functional. So even though I'm making it out of wood, it's going to be, all of the actions are going to be centered on steel pins, cold rolled steel pins, and brass sleeves, bearing sleeves. So the brass tubing The first ones I've cut by hand using my mini miter system and my mini miter saw, just having a squaring block, putting the saw right up against that, using it as a square, cutting it down, and then gradually hand filing it in that same squaring block using the squaring edge for the file, and filing down the bearing and then checking the fit, filing down, checking the fit. And I did that for the rotator bearing, and it had to fit in the recess of the base, and I filed it down until I just got it in there, because I want this, like I said, I want this to be tight but smooth and goozy. So the bearing fit perfectly into the base recess, and so then I was set out to do the pin. I had to do that on the lathe. So I chopped off a piece of quarter inch cold rolled steel, this really hard stuff. It took forever to cut it off with a jigsaw with a really good metal cutting blade, even with lubrication and everything. I went through two blades just cutting off a piece of stock. It was really, really hard steel. First thing I did is I took a caliper measurement from the actual base to figure the absolute maximum length the pin should be. So the first thing I did is I turned on the lathe and just using a Sharpie made a sort of a broad line on the piece. And you know, if you have that blue machinist stuff like Scott has, you can use that, but I just use Sharpie. And then once the Sharpie had dried, I just, as it was continuing to turn, I take the caliper and I put it down right against the edge of the pin that's cut, and I just kind of rub a little line into the Sharpie, and that line is the absolute maximum length of the pin as when it's going to be finished. I faced the end of the pin that was on the outside, just a little cutting oil, a few little quick passes, and just, you know, make sure that's flat. I also put a tiny little chamfer on the outside, fillet, bevel, however you want to describe it, just on the outside of the one end of the pin. And then brought the cutter around and did a sort of a plunging cut, taking into consideration the angle of the cutter that I'm using, so that when I got into about two-thirds of the way in, that the cutaway would just about line up with that line. Again, putting a bevel in there so that when I part it, that I'll be able to, you know, face it down and it's going to be exactly the right length. So I turned the steel and cut that little piece out about two-thirds of the way into the steel. And then before I parting it, I was going to polish up the pin. Started with 220 grit sandpaper to take all the sort of patina off, and then went to 330 grit. And after it was sort of cleaning off the patina, I switched to 2000 grit with cutting oil, and did that wet and completely polished up the pin before parting it. You cannot use too much cutting oil when you're parting. Oil, 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 more oil, 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 until dropped it off. And then after I had the pin parted, I turned the pin around, put that in the chuck, and just did some very, you know, easy facing on that pin, just to take off the little chunk that was left and do a little, you know, fine finishing. And the end result, I took the brass bearing sleeve from the rotator that I had fabricated and made it up with the pin, and it's totally smooth and goozy, and it was a very optimistic look at how the action would be, and I was very satisfied with the whole process. I was like, at that point, it was like, yeah, this really is going to be coming together. But yeah, there's still a lot to do. I mean, it's coming together, but this week has gone on much longer than I thought it would. I thought I'd have it all done by today, but when I realized that I'd have to make these squaring blocks, that took a little while to design them and to figure out, you know, how big they had to be for the different processes. And also, you know, I'm working very carefully at this point because I've got weeks of work in these parts, and the very last thing that I need to do is to break apart and have to restart over from scratch, refabricating a new part, just because I was working impatiently or not thinking. So I've been taking more and more time to think every single operation and eliminate all possible problems before I just go and do it, because I just can't afford to be screwing it up at this point. But what's left to do is I basically today I'm going to be fabricating the rest of the pins and bearings, and then I'm going to have to, you know, use the lathe to chop off some of the smaller diameter pins, again to hold the latch link, and the medium pin to hold the pull, to actually for the puller that goes through the base. And you have to make that today, and then I'm going to have to do the finishing operations on the rotator head to get that size for the latch link for the rotation. And there's an internal, another 45 degree internal contour in the bottom of that I have to do. I also have two 45 degree squaring blocks that I made up for the base, because I have to do one last operation. I'm going to have to carve out a 45 degree angle on the interior of the base for the rotator for the far end, and that I have to do that yet this weekend. And then I'm going to have to assemble all of the components into the various parts, because the rotator has three different components yet that have to be merged together on one bearing. And I have to finish the mangle operations on the puller do the recess for the roller. So there's still a lot to do, and then the final assembly of the whole thing. So I mean, the original deadline for Project Egress when I signed on was the 30th, turns out I never would have made that. But I guess it turned out that everybody was behind schedule, because I think a few days in they pushed off the deadline, and now it's here. It's been pushed off to the 12th of July. So all parts have to arrive at the Smithsonian by the 12th, which is a pretty fine window. So I've got like another, at least another 10 days to get all this done. So I'm not pushing the schedule. Like I said, I'm not gonna run ahead of things and do something half-assed and break something. I'm getting to the point where these parts are getting very small, and the latch link, for example, I mean the short grain issues on the latch link are going to be extreme, because I'm going to have to be milling a radius on a very small piece of wood and then drilling it through a rather large hole for that. There's just a lot to consider. So it's got to be done carefully. That's where we are, day 14. So I'll be back probably, see how much work I get done this weekend. So I guess I'll be back here in a couple days, few days, for number 7, getting ready for the final countdown. The final countdown. That's it. I'm Fran. Thanks, everybody. Thanks to all the patrons on Patreon for hanging in there and making all these cool projects possible, making this participation in Project Egress possible. You made that happen, patrons on Patreon. And I'll be back real soon. All right.